Hello, we're back in actually last match for today between Teen Alpha and You Only Love Once. This is going to be the Gigabyte 16. And this is going to be the quarterfinal. It's a best of one. I'm sorry that everything looks like this. I just got in, so I'm sorry that everything looks like bloop. But yeah, we're just going to go do it. We have a really stacked game. These two teams just beat two, well, on paper, stronger teams and more known teams. Team Alpha just beat... just one from London Conspiracy, and Oshiliki Gaming, aka YOLO Gaming, just one from Goomba Gaming. And with me, as you just heard saying, hey, it's Lair GG. Man, we didn't cast him some well, and now we just jump straight into a Gigabyte match.
Yeah, this is gonna be an interesting one, like pretty stacked teams. They seem pretty unknown, but we have Mind Control, the ex-captain of basically unknown. And we have Team Alpha here with the famous Bakemono. He's like on the top 10 in the leaderboards, I think. Like 7.4k?
Man, so, those are just strong teams.
I'm pretty impressed that they took out named teams already. Like, I think it's just a mix for the Gigabyte Challenge, so will be interesting.
Yeah. And 2 seconds remaining.
Yeah, Tiny Wisp.
They just won from strong teams. That's like what I'm actually amazed. Like, this is not what you were expecting.
Yes, but best of one format makes it possible, I think.
Definitely does. But yeah, I heard Tiny Man, you were gonna say something about that.
Well, the famous IO Tiny Combo. I think there's not much to add about it. It's super strong. They're not on Radiant though, but I think it's also good on Dire.
And you can still do the stacking, so.
Yeah. And we got a Winter Wyvern as a counter, I think. We had first pick.
Oshiliki did. So, first pick was Winter Wyvern, and then they got back.
Interesting.
But they actually picked it into Winter Wyvern.
Yeah. I mean, it can work. I think it can work. But. Like, Wyvern is really good against Tiny and Wisp.
Yeah, it's
and of
just,
course, the Spirit Breaker.
It's really ballsy, and yeah. Spirit Breaker here as well, that's just... Wherever you go, you're gonna get followed. And that's just gonna be
Storm
tough.
Spirit.
Yeah, they really want long-range initiation. Like, they have global presence with the Spirit Breaker already, and the Storm to jump. Like, Wisp is gonna have a hard time.
Yeah, this is... That's gonna be fun for him. But the mid lane lineup now, because if you're gonna be what Storm Spirit versus IO Tiny, he will need support in the beginning, definitely.
I think you're lagging a bit.
Am I lagging a bit? Where?
You, or is it me? I don't think it's me. Am I lagging for you?
No, you sound good. Am I lagging?
Yeah, then it's you, yeah. 5 seconds
remaining. That's odd. I don't seem to be lagging or dropping frames or anything in OBS, so...
Maybe it's the TeamSpeak. Oh, 1 sec, I reconnect.
You reconnect? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, while we're at it... Yeah, this is this Storm Spirit. There you go, you're back?
Yeah, but... Still.
Yeah, we can just switch over to a different TS, though. Oh, but there are gonna be people joining, that's kind of a problem.
Is it... If I'm not lagging for you, I think
yeah,
it's...
Yeah, I'm gonna join myself real fast. Be right back.
Yeah.
Disconnected. Connected. Channel switched.
Okay. I'm back.
Yeah, seems a bit better, but yeah.
Yeah. Just guys, it if it's also happening on the stream, just tell us and then we'll fix it, I guess.
Radiant team.
Kind of went straight into this with. Yeah.
Seems like there's also a problem with Twitch.
Is Twitch also?
Yes, something is not working today. Everything's a bit laggy. Oh yeah, we have a Nexus and a Rubick. Both are really, really strong against Spirit Breaker and Storm.
Yeah, this... But would that be enough though? This, because Nexus has... You can... At the moment it looks like it's gonna be an offlane Nexus. You can shut him down quite effectively just with the Winter Wyvern alone. Just having Arctic Burn there. So.
Radiant team pick.
Yeah, Gyra and Wintervive on combined should handle Nyx pretty good.
And then if he starts ganking it, you know, usually you know the time is, you know, when he gets level 5, you just buy a couple sentries, and if you already take out the early ganks from him, disruptor. It makes him...
Yeah, just a disruptor.
Man, they just hate poor this Wisp. Combo.
Poor Wisp.
Well, okay, so Wisp is gonna hate his life today. That's like the one thing, that's for sure.
Yeah, and Tiny can't hit anything because the target, like... Like in during the early and mid game, Tiny might be able to one-shot people, but when it goes to the later stages of the game, he won't have the burst to kill someone, and then Wintervyvern will just tomb, and Tiny burst is literally gone. Will be really hard to kill something.
Indeed.
But on the other hand, like you have a Nyx lurking around, and you can just relocate onto the Nyx and. Suddenly, three people appear from nowhere.
That's true, but that means that Nyx needs to do get this level 6, and they don't have. Yeah, you're just expecting them that they don't have any sentries out together with their observer ward, so they can't spot him. If they're just diligent versus a Nyx player, your Nyx assassin becomes quite worthless. I know how it feels.
Yeah, so that's but, why. Like Nyx forces so much sentry wards from the supports and alone that like it's a lot of gold and a lot of passive pressure.
That's true, but with the disruptor and the Wintervive, and they're not really heroes that need gold at all.
Like, yeah, they can just sit back and farm with their lineup in general. Mm. But
we're just gonna see how that goes. It does indeed apply a lot of pressure there, and passive pressure just always, you know, as long as he's off the map, you're always scared that he might be ganking, might be doing something that you're not expecting. So but yeah, they banned out an Undying on Team Alpha in the end over a disruptor. Do you agree with that? Wouldn't you ban out? It would be more, a lot more obvious to ban out the disruptor on Team Alpha.
It depends how they want to approach the game. Like, you know, usually when you go IO Tiny, you want a really solid safe lane. That means you go for a Viper or a Razor, so you have a really stable dual lane there and can put IO Tiny mid and you still dominate your safe lane with two people. So if you ban out the Undying, you open up the possibility to pick a weaker safe lane hero. And this is what I just did. They got a Juggernaut instead of a more solid safe lane like a Razor or a Viper. So I can agree with that in a certain way.
Yeah, I actually hadn't thought of that, so that's actually a really good way indeed to put it there. And
like Spiritbreaker will have a really hard time. Just imagine you give them Undying instead of the Disruptor and they just go dual lane. And then you will have pressure on your own safe lane.
Yeah, that's just not something that you can play against in the early game. Because you need to make, you indeed need to make a lot of space for the IO and Tiny combination.
Also, exactly.
Also, I just reminded myself to do that. Make sure that you put your mic on open. I don't know if it's, I don't think it's ticketed, but you might have a lot of live viewers. So, just FYI. But yeah, guys, this is the Gigabyte number 16. This is the quarterfinal between OSG, aka YOLO, and Team Alpha. Two teams that actually took out two of the stronger teams here, Goomba and LC. And with me is Lair GG for this match.
Hey.
So yeah,
let's do this.
Yeah, let's introduce it. Mind Control. He was from Balkan Bears, no?
No, he was the captain of Basically Unknown.
That was it, yeah.
Before they parted ways, and I think he got replaced by Arise.
Yes. No, I think Arise and Microsoft actually both played together for a time.
Yeah.
The same. Ah, doesn't matter. Anyway, for the Radiant side, for YOLO Gaming, or YOLO, we have Mind Control playing the Storm Spirit. We have Tip playing the Disruptor. We have Slavi playing the Spirit Breaker. Big Nun playing the Winter Wyvern. And Exmo playing the Gyrocopter.
On Alpha side, we got Harry on the Wisp, Midgey on the Rubick, King gonna play the Tiny, Noob on Nyx Assassin, and the Bakemono on his core role, Juggernaut.
Yeah, these are gonna be 2-2-1 lanes from Alpha, most likely.
Yes.
Nyx on the off lane, he's gonna have a tough time there.
Yeah, I think he will stay level 1 for quite some time.
Yeah, I'm just wondering, who are they gonna set mid? Are they gonna send the Disruptor or the Winter Wyvern mid to help out the...
The Storm?
Yeah.
I think... If you... Like, Boofy... Like... Disruptor doesn't provide anything if you send him mid, right?
Yeah, he doesn't.
And actually, he needs levels. So, he wants to pull. So, you usually don't send him. But, on the same... Like, at the same moment, you need two heroes down there to control the Nyx. So if you send whoever into mid, Nyx will get too much. So, like, you can't really send someone there. Like, maybe you zone the Nyx for quite some time, maybe minute 3. And then you rotate someone into middle for to stack for Storm and just stay behind him so he's safe.
So they're gonna, in your eyes, they're gonna leave him alone for some time and then go at it. I think they might just actually start rotating in the beginning already with Big Nami, since he bought boots.
No, he will just play the high ground ward in middle. Common nowadays. But he's doing the really obvious one, wow. That's, yeah, it got
he get baited out. That's underneath
yeah,
that the tower, was, right?
You shouldn't do that, yeah, like you have, they can see him in the middle of the river. You need to put the ward on your side of the hill if you want to do that.
Can they actually straight up
do they anything? No
yeah,
sentries.
They bought sentries.
Oh, they yeah.
Harry just bought them.
Was smart. He
no, no,
Harry. Money, but yeah, that's tricky. It will delay Iris bottle.
30 seconds. But yeah, would you say that's worth it? Because if he can just get the rune now and get the ward, it's still part of his investment back.
It's good, but usually Rubik should have.
What? Okay, that was avoidable. Like, for sure. But okay, yeah, it doesn't matter that much. He should be able to get off in time.
Yeah, it's no big deal. Maybe it's some special tactic. Who knows?
Yeah. Oh, it's of course to throw somebody up there.
Oh, yeah. That's actually. Oh, he broke okay. The tether.
Okay, yeah, that wasn't what he meant. That was a mistake.
Well, now Tiny can't block mid lane. That's a really... Storm will have the creep wave on his side. That was unfortunate.
Yeah, that's a big win for them. And there you go, they straight up denied. They did not get the last hit though, so that's actually 50 gold wasted.
But they send the Wyvern mid, that's interesting. Like, Nyx will have a really, really good time bottom now.
Yeah, he should be able to get some easy levels.
Yeah, like, Disruptor can't do anything to him. And on top... Yeah, on the top lane, like... Miggy and Bakemono should handle the Spirit Breaker well. Like, they can't really do anything to him, but at least they farm.
Yeah, unless he really makes a mistake, he should just be fine. And from level 2, even if he makes a small mistake, as long as it's after the lift, you can just run out.
Yeah.
It should be okay there. And yeah, this is what I was thinking about. They're just going to put Winter Wyvern mid and do this dual lane mid for some time.
I think that hurts them too much. Like, Nyx is already, like, he needs 4 XP for level 2. If he goes to the pool, he will have level 2 already. I mean, Spirit Breaker, of course, has the same, but I think Nyx's game impact will be higher, way higher.
Level 1 turn to bolt really doesn't do anything versus Nyx.
Yeah.
Just using Tango and then let the base movement, regen just kick in and it should be just fine. Oh, Exmo. Yeah, they can't zone him out anymore. Now he has Spike Carapace and he should be able to run out.
No.
Level 1 glimpse is so short range, so it's not really
600.
Yeah, it's like nothing.
Wow. You have to auto attack range.
Yeah. You have to be way too close to really get a good glimpse of.
Wyvern is on a journey here with a haste rune on the top side. And Rubik's charge. I think this Rubik's in trouble.
Oh. Yeah, he might just gonna die here. Oh,
oh
no!
Nice, nice.
That lift, but he's still slow.
He can just creep around the trees.
Yeah. Mbake comes in, but Slavi, he should be just fine. A little bit too much HP to really dive there. Good lift there. really the advantages of just having a instant disable there. What I want to see this game is when he tries to charge away, that charge gets stolen and he just runs after him.
Yeah.
It's so clowny. It's so fun though.
Dom is stacking already. Yeah.
Is he gonna be on time here though? There is a sentry. Oh. He might only just get the medium camp.
Yeah, both teams just stacking and farming now. Alright.
Yeah, that was actually a journey for Winter Wild, and he also put down the.
Yeah, that was really, really good, actually. Oh. That's really aggressive.
Yeah, he needs to look out a little bit. He's not level 6 just yet, and even if he was level 6, there's almost no real mana to get out with.
Yeah. Like, it seems that the Wyvern start helps. Oh, he missed the combo, that's sad. Seems that the Wyvern presence in mid from the start helped the Storm, actually. Like, he has 14 CS, he's out farming the Tiny.
And we missed it. He did use Spike Carapace, but they were able to get him.
Yeah,
with
he got
back.
Level 2 Glimpse, that's no way. Level 2 Glimpse and level 3
Rocket Barrage.
Yeah, that's just sad. Oh, there's a charge and Wisp. Nice, cancelled it. Rubik saw the rotating in.
Oh, but they still keep on going here after King. Oh, those bastards.
Oh, that
RNG. And they're able to get him here. There's going to be a nice impale coming out there. But they just ignore him and go
Wisp
for Ari here.
Dead.
He's dead. And now Noob. Yeah, he's not going to get anybody here. Even the invisibility room popped by Storm.
That's huge.
Yeah, that's just...
Storm will hit a really early level 6. And after that, they can't kill him.
No, there's... But only if you get the combination of there and follow it up with lift and...
You need to get the third player to kill him then.
Yeah, you just need to make sure that... You need everything to follow up there. If it's not there, then it's just not gonna be good. Yo, green dude, something bad is happening in your bottom. Oh, just typing something in chat. There we go. Okay, and... Just coming back a little bit now, and yeah, this middle lane, yeah. This is the presence indeed of Winter Wyvern, and even just being close, going into jungle, stopping the pool camp, it's just what the hard camp is just making it work so much.
Yeah.
And just look at it, they keep on putting down sentries now. This sentry is a little bit. They didn't have to.
That sentry is off.
Yep, just a little bit. Well, they're putting out a little bit more rest here, and. They just can't go into mind control here. Oh my god. This is failure sentry here.
Bottom, like, he's dying so fast, bottom. Like.
I wasn't even looking there. That's
it's just, he gets glimpsed, rocket barrage, he's dead in like 1 second.
That's just... That is the problem with the Nyx here. Once the Disruptor has his level, you need to already have your level 6.
Disruptor is close to level 6 already, and we're 6 minutes in game. Same for Storm, he's also one creep away from level 6. Spirit Breaker also close to level 6.
Yeah, so far YOLO has been getting whatever they want. Level skills 4 to 0, even a regen rune right now on the Disruptor. We can just start, maybe go mid, and they might actually be able to get a pick off here with the 3 of them. Storm is level 6 right now. But just zip
they
it
lack
on Tiny.
The damage. I think they lack damage on Tiny. They need to kill the Wisp.
But the zip there, they should be able to maybe single him out. But they will need to move forward, and Disruptor need to look out to not show himself. They might just go on a warding trip here with the two of them.
Yeah.
Disruptor, oh man, he's also already close to level 6.
Yeah, it's insane. Like, he literally pulled every wave bottom on. Like.
You're getting so much, like, even though I want to see Juggernaut is pretty strong laner still. As long as it's not somebody with an escape, you should be able to kill them off and...
Look at this build. No crit, no healing ward, stats and Blade Fury. That's interesting.
Yeah, I can get why you put now more points into Blade Fury. Just, you know, you just need it at the moment.
The only way to kill Slavi on the offlane, but even then it seems they can't do anything to him.
Not at all.
It's really tricky. Like, they picked a really, really greedy safe lane. It's like one of the most greedy lanes ever with Rubik. He doesn't do anything on the lane. And Jugger needs like level 6 to do something like really effective. Same goes for the mid lane, and they get punished for it really, really hard.
Yeah, and they keep on expanding sentries here to just deward the sentry. Oh no, this is actually a random one, never mind there.
Oh, bottom. Yeah, Nyx got glimpsed into the cooldown, yeah, and it's just dead.
Less right clicks there from X, just more than enough to kill him off there. And they're actually gonna go for a really early centric build here. Base boots into a drum. But even a Basil is on top of it.
Yeah, they want to press their advantage. Like, Wisp lineups are the weakest at the early game. And if you punish the early game really hard and transition with Elite into the mid game, like, Wisp is not that strong anymore.
No, if he gets shut down, even if he just has a bottle like he has now, that's just not enough. He doesn't even have his boots or anything. It's
he doesn't need boots, but the problem is if you lose the laning stage really hard, or not really hard, but if you get shut down on every lane literally and you have a Wisp, you can't even get him level 6. It's impossible.
Well, the only real way actually to do it in my eyes is just get the stacks.
Yeah, they have to take the stacks, exactly. Mm. Well,
with the stacks, they are able to at least get back a little bit more. But they need to really, really make sure that Ayo is there. Because if the Ayo is not there, I think the stacks are fairly wasted. Because he needs to get a level 6 to get his lineup going for Alpha.
Yeah. But I think they won't give them the stacks uncontested. If they see that Ayo is moving, they will move into the jungle S3.
Yeah, definitely. Let's see. Do they have anything yet? Yeah, they even have two wards on the Winter Wyvern, so if they see them disappear, they will definitely smoke up as well with the smoke that he has in his inventory and just go there and contest it, because there's no real way for them to do anything about it. Oh, but Slavi now, he's getting dived here. He's charging forward. He's getting away from here, but now Mind Control comes in. Oh,
oh, nice.
That was close, but Mind Control was able to live through the Omni Slash there. Yeah, that dive a little bit aggressive, and that means that there are still no kills for Team Alpha here, the team that beat London Conspiracy.
But they played together with this roster a few months ago, so they know each other pretty well and their playstyle.
On the side of Team Alpha?
Yes.
Okay, I thought so, because I know that YOLO is pretty new. And oh, the glimpse!
Oh,
we're back.
Miggy.
And now they're gonna look to contest the stacks or even take them away from
if they take the stacks, this game gets significantly.
There's gonna be the static storm though. Microphone gets put into the air and now he keeps on zipping forward. Harry is already gonna die right now. King is gonna be the next on the list. There's no real way for him to get out. What? He's still alive? Okay, there we go. Overcharge attacks more than enough to kill him off. And now with the Winter Wyvern and with the Storm here. What? Pakamono, he comes in. He's spinning out. He's still gonna get the charge on top of him. Microphone here. The Gold Embrace just in time. And now there's gonna be Slavi. He has Nether Strike. Bakemono, he's gonna take the fall here. Mind Control is still alive. They're all coming in. They're waiting for the Impale here. 2 seconds. 1 second. Are they gonna be able to hit Disruptor here? They're walking around. He's thinking about it, but yeah, they should be able to get him here right now. There you go. Impale is there, but still.
That was nice. But let them.
But still, all that for just him, it's not
and
enough.
And Storm lift through all of that.
And now X, he comes in. Whoa, he's really aggressive. He is a little bit alone. Okay, his team is now there to back him up. Long zip in. Oh, that's going to be a dead Rubick already. There's a nice avalanche there, but Harry, he's going to be focused on right now. There's the bash. He dies as well. Now King is the next one on the list.
Yeah.
Cold Embrace on time again here. The slow coming out here, and now Bakemono, he walks in. That is not what he is supposed to do. He's not even going to get a kill here, right now here. Oh no,
he got
get one. But still, is it worth it?
Yeah, that was 900 gold for that kill. That was worth it.
That was worth it?
Okay. Yeah, 900 gold.
Yeah, okay, that's salvage the fight, yeah. But still, in the grand scheme of things, it's essentially, when they start walking into the jungle, I believe YOLO had about 8 kills or something.
Yeah, like
in total, and now they have 15.
Literally, it went from here to here to here to here and ended here. With people respawning twice.
Yeah, man, that was just one of the longest drawn out fights.
It was really impressive. Like, Storm was literally here and got tombed with like 20 HP, and he made it to the rune, and I think a region spawned and this allowed him to jump in again.
Yeah, that was... And now...
S4 confirmed.
Wasn't it Sumail though?
I think it's still called the S4 rune though.
It still is, okay. Yeah, S4 is just
the master of runes.
Yeah. Doesn't he always get like the DD more and the haste?
Yeah, he gets like haste and DD every time he needs them.
Yeah. And then you're in a pub and you get like, why do I only get illusion runes? Fuck this game. Yeah, there's no chance in hell that Team Alpha is able to defend this tower here.
No, it's gone. Like, we're 12 minutes in now, they have a 7.5k lead, 15-2.
Noob goes Infis, and yeah, there is no dust at the moment to Slavi. He's gonna probably purchase it after this.
Like, Wisp has level 6 though, and Nyx also got level 6, or even level 7. So if they get some pickoffs, they might can come back into this game.
Yeah, the question is on who are the big the kill streaks right now. Yeah, okay, the big kill streak right now is on Mind Control, on Storm Spirit, as well as on the Winter Wyvern.
Yeah, so like
they need to go for those two kills just to, you know, use the comeback mechanic there.
Oh, Storm Invis. Yeah. You will find Bakemono in their jungle.
He's stacked this one. He's lingering around.
They're going for the. No way.
He spins.
He's waiting.
He's just waiting. Okay, he's gonna wait to the end of the stack. No, he's just gonna go in right now. He doesn't have Blade Fury, he does have his ultimate though. But it goes to the creep and here you go.
He's dead.
There's gonna be the TP out. No, Lift is still there. That was not worth it.
No.
You're too far ahead right now to call that worth.
That was 800 gold for Rubik.
That's an happy Rubik, man. That's his arcanes if you want to.
Yeah. Most likely.
Games and some war, TTP, smoke.
Oh, they're going in there on Wisp.
Yeah, there we go, but it's just gonna be.
What was that?
Yeah, you know, just show him who's boss, you know?
Yeah. Get out.
He knows that he can't kill him without, you know, dying himself, and. So he just gives up on it. Now he might just go after Bakemono again, just to, you know, charge there, show who's boss, and there you go, that's exactly what he will do.
Oh, he canceled it.
Insta cancel, okay, that's what I was expecting, but yeah. Might as well, you know, finish up there. I think there's some noob on the top lane anyway. What do you think he's going for? He has 1200 gold.
Who?
Next assassin noob.
Well, he needs arcanes. Like, you can't play Nyx without arcanes. It's simply not possible. And here we go. Yeah,
yeah, that was to be expected.
Like. Your spells cost so much mana and they have such a low cooldown that, like, arcanes are just required. And we got a big smoke, 5-man smoke.
Yeah, but what are they able to find here at the moment? Nothing. So they might just transition this into tier 2 push.
But
do they have enough
that's like the team secret, just scare your opponent smoke. Like, they move into the jungle smoke. Place wards, and in the meantime, like, they're stacked there, and yeah, they're not even farming the wave here. So, like, even though they waste the smoke, they still get wards up and scare their opponents, like, even more.
And if they weren't scared and they were actually trying to farm the lane or the jungle, they would have died.
Yeah, exactly.
So, for both of the teams, it's kind of the play that you have to make. Yeah, for both there's not the biggest worth out there, but yeah, still in the end YOLO is taking the in the end is gonna take the better trade out of it, especially with, you know, being so far ahead. I wouldn't say you just have the better farming tools already.
Yeah, but yeah, also they're pushing out both lanes, top and middle, and now they're most likely trade 2 tier 2s or 1 tier 2.
Do you have a fortification?
Or tier 1, like, you make that trade any day.
It's just okay. The Team Alpha is just not ready right now to do a base race. If Tiny had his Aghanims, then yeah, then you can actually go for a base race right now. You might actually win it. With Team YOLO, their lineup is not really made to push down towers fast.
No.
Creep clear, yes, but tower destruction.
But it's like Team Alpha made the right call there. Like, all they can do is dodge fights. Like, they have to give up literally every turn now and just hope and play the high ground defense. No way they can fight into this. Here comes a charge.
And who is it? It's gonna be on Hari. There we go. But they should soon be able to see that everybody's behind there. If he actually continues on this, it might be troublesome. His team is TPing though. But is it gonna be enough? Yeah, he cancelled. Is he still running into somebody?
Bloodstone completed on mind control.
Nice timing, 17 minutes.
It's really fast.
Loop, he goes in fist. He should be able to see Slav here. And they just want to cover their retreat.
Here comes the jump, but it's too short.
It's too short.
Oh!
They fight him! What? That was... What? He canceled the TP there. Well, the backline, Rubik is fighting up versus Mikto. He's going to lose the fight. At the same time, King is fighting up versus the entirety of YOLO here. And he's also just going to lose the fight straight away.
King canceled his TP at 0001 for whatever reason.
I don't think he canceled it. I don't think he meant to do that, though.
Yeah, like, no... I was like, Storm will find him. And then Storm jumped on the Rubik. I was like, what happened?
The Storm didn't see him, like, he was good hidden there, you know, he was in the fox spot there, so he wasn't able to see him. That was the correct play from him, but then, I think he thought he was already in the base and just wanted to start walking.
And maybe too many people TP'd on the same building in the fountain, and...
He forgot to shift Q?
No, I think, like, he maybe got a longer TP, because someone, like, they clicked somewhere into the base.
But still, why would you...
I don't know.
Cancel it.
It can happen sometimes.
Yeah, shit happens. But that's not what you want to have happening when you're so far behind and you're the number one position here.
Disastrous, actually. But
well, they're gonna go. He's just charging in against Slavi and he starts walking back. And now he's without creep. And yeah, he just TP's out straight away. Are they gonna be in time here with the relocate there or not?
No.
Good. That's just, you know, the mini stun from Juggernaut not being there anymore. Just being able to TP out then.
That's a tier 2 for maybe at 1.
Yeah, they're doing a lot of damage.
Look at Big
Gnome, he has a Glimmer Cape! There's gonna be the curse! They find King, they're gonna pull back Bakemono. He doesn't have his ultimate. Mind Control's taking a lot of damage here, but there's gonna be the Snake Stone Kinetic Cube. Keeping them in. Mind Control's still alive. They do have the damage here with the last crit of Bakemono, but still. Already 2 people down, now 3 down, and Storm buybacks, or just he just insta respawned there?
He didn't die, or did he?
Yeah, Storm died. After he got out of Cold Embrace, he got the crit from the Jugger.
Oh yeah, I think it was instant Bloodstone respawn.
He still has 7 charges, so... He's building up towards the BKB.
He's only 11, so he respawns like super fast with... I think he had like 15 charges, or 13.
And maybe even less, but... Let's see, if you have 7, you come back from 11 or... Oh, it doesn't even matter. Gives a red ass. Yeah. Anyway, he's building up towards the BKB right now.
Everyone from Manta. Yeah, well, Manta is actually really smart, yeah.
Let's see, what do they have? Yeah, it's versus the Jugger.
They tank the Omni Lash. Yeah. It's like really good.
They just gave the invisibility here to Gyro.
What?
I gave the invisibility rune to the Gyrocopter. I would have maybe preferred it because Spirit Break. Oh, he has a Shadow Blade, okay.
Yeah.
I was already looking like you're better off giving it to the Spirit Break and just let him scout with it.
Oh, that smoke. I think Storm is in trouble. Storm is in trouble.
Yeah, he's gonna get caught out. He's gonna die here before this team can come in to help him out. Gaul is on. Winter's Curse is actually on cooldown here right now. This is actually a pretty bad fight to be taking here for the side of YOLO. Big Gnome, he is able to get out, but Bakemono. Well, they're gonna go back in here. Nether Strike, Rubik, he gets blown up. There's gonna be the Impale Slav. You know, Bakemono is going to try and get some right clicks in, but there's gonna be the Cold Embrace. Now they have to start to retreat here. It's actually 2-for-2 so far.
He canceled it.
And, ooh, no. Noob is able to get out here with the Spike Carapace. At least YOLO was able to salvage the fight a little bit, but still, it was a victory for Team Alpha.
It was 2-for-2, yeah, but they got more out of it, for sure.
Storm plus Disruptor. It's worth more. That was a little bit too fast for Mind Control to be walking out that far without his team. It was in the vicinity, but just not close enough.
Yeah, it was like a Vendetta into Impale, into Rubik Lift, into Relocate, into Omni Lash. Like, just too much.
It is too much for him right now, and You know, once he has his BKB, like, that's a perfect play to make, because you can just, you know, BKB. You know, once you see the Vendetta, you're able to do it.
The Roshan now.
Yeah, there's still no way for them to stop it here. Even although they lost a bunch of fights here for YOLO, you know, they didn't get the better trace, they're still just keep on going, getting ahead. They're already 12k ahead right now and up to 7.5k in XP.
Like Aegis Storm.
That's Aegis carry in the game.
But not sure if they're ready yet to approach high ground.
Depend if they can maybe get a pick off on the tiny, then
even then, like, they have like no capability to siege the high ground properly. Like, there's no one who can hit the building basically.
No real long, yeah, maybe with Cold Embrace with Arctic Burn from
Big Yeah.
But yeah, like, that's like sieging high ground, what, every 40, 45 seconds. Oh no, Bakemono, he might just be called out here.
Trouble.
He is dead. Is he able to get off an Omni Slash? He's not. There's gonna be the Impale and his Whiffed. Yeah, that's one of the pickups that they need.
Yeah,
they
no,
might
I
just be able to do it.
Yes,
what use? What that charge was just insta quit there, and oh, Microtor, he goes in, he finds Harvey. There's gonna be the cooldown on top of him as well. Whisk is getting low, Whisk might just die here, and yes, he will. Microtor is still alive, there's gonna be the golden brace on top of him. And is how do they have enough magic damage here to kill him in the meantime? No, they just toss something on top of him while he tries to zip out. That's the Aegis, but it is a tier 3 tower here for YOLO and Team Alpha. They're looking well. Not that good at the moment, because there's gonna be the zipping. King, oh, look at the curse! They get them all! Bakemono charged, he still has his ultimate. No, he actually doesn't! He used it somewhere. And yeah, they don't get the Rex for now, but they will just back off here with the buyback use on Rubick.
Again, they come out ahead, like, they got a tower. I mean, they lost the edges, but still, like, on the next approach, they can just take at least the range Rex, I think.
They actually got over 3k gold out of this, plus 2k XP more.
Yeah.
They're just getting more ahead and ahead. You know, with an Iotiny, you kind of never want to really rule them out, because it's still an Iotiny, but it's really, really looking dire.
Yeah, just 5 men, and then I think Nautilus added, or Kuroki, Wisp is one of the weaker, if you can make the trade-off between a Wisp and a Winter Wyvern in a 5-on-5, you always want the Winter Wyvern, basically. And that's why I think they left the Wisp in pool and just build a 5-man lineup around it.
If they leave the Winter Wyvern in, you might, and you pick it up first phase, yeah, then you're...
Yeah.
Picking up an IO in 2, that is just ballsy again.
Yeah, their 5-man is so strong, they have cooldown,
Static Storm.
Many AoE controls, Storm to jump around.
They even have a Spirit Break with his abilities that goes through BKB.
Yeah, it's just...
The lookout, they draw out a line here from Team Alpha. Or was it from Spirit Break? I'm not completely sure, but...
Yes, yeah.
They're like, they're there, let's just go run into them with the smoke and try to kill them. There's an invisibility rune again, but do they have sentry yet?
Yeah,
one on high ground here. And he's close. He knows that he's not being shown right now. If he gets any closer, he will. And there's gonna be the jump in. Migi, yeah, he is found here. He's gonna get pulled back. There's gonna be the cooldown as well. No, oh no, Bakemono, he is gone with the Winter's Curse here. He's gonna take a fall before being able to do anything. BKB use. 3 people dead. Slavi goes after King here, but he will just call it off. And there you go, GG.
That was really well played by OSG.
And even Harry dies in the last second. Yeah, that was so well played by Team YOLO here.
Like, they exploited the weakness of the landing stage and just went with it. Really impressive performance.
Yeah, there was just no real way from the Team Alpha yesterday. Just well behind so far, they just weren't able to get back into the game, and that said, YOLO wasn't giving them any chances at all either. And yeah, that was actually the Gigabyte for us. This is this was Gigabyte number 16. This was the quarterfinal between YOLO and Team Alpha, two teams that defeated Goomba Gaming and London Conspiracy. I'm gonna take a quick look at who's gonna be playing next. With I am Sander from Swiss DC. With me was Lair GG. Lair, you got any shoutouts?
Yeah. Sorry, King. I feel really sorry for you.
He's one of the people that you play with from time to time.
Yeah. Also, Bakemono. I'm good friends with them. Like, sad that they got crushed like that. It's really hard for my soul, you know.
It was a crush, like. Team Alpha. They're a German team, right?
Nah, they're like completely international, I believe.
International. Okay, I wasn't completely sure.
I think Boof are just mixed internationals.
But okay, that was that was actually it for us. Follow our channel as well. We'll be doing a little bit more of GDL once the matches are up there, and we'll also have our own tournament soon as well. We will be at Gamescom, so you know, come join us there. And I just looked it up. Osliki Gaming, aka YOLO, will be playing versus either Team Alternate or Pup Players. You can see that at the Gigabyte channel from Join Dota, so you can just swap over there and see who they're going to be playing next. This was us. I'm going to go away. And Lair, he's also going to go. He's not allowed to stay.
Good night.